Hi, Joyce Fernandes back again. The first speech is the in the news. This is the icebreaker speech. This will be the first time that you are formally presenting a message that you have time to create, creating your introduction, creating your body, creating your conclusion. When you look at the handout that I'm looking at right now on the computer, the first line says, a news item of, or story that is of interest to you. That is so important for you to understand. You're going to speak about something that is of interest to you, that perhaps you would normally speak about to a friend or to a family member, like something you heard on the radio or you saw on the internet or you were watching television or somebody told you about a story that you are pretty sure is true. So you want to vet your stories to make sure they're landed in reality, but it could be on any topic. It could be from video gaming to what's happening in your town. Like maybe there's new legislation for schools or for like a landfills or something like that that is significant to you. It doesn't have to please us. It should be the topic is for you. The way you present it is to an audience. It's to somebody else. So you have to be clear in your introduction. You have to be clear in your paraphrasing of the story, which is the body, and then your conclusion will be your opinion, why you picked this particular topic. But the topics are always going to be from your genuine interest. And how you find it is where you would find it normally. Hopefully you are engaged citizen and you do know something that's going on. I know personally for me, I could be a news junkie and I really can't do that anymore. It's getting to the point where it's becoming emotionally very stressful to listen to so many different opinions and thoughts. So I pick and choose where I get my news, but I do try to find a variety of places so it's not always the same voice or from the same political perspective. So I get a well-roundedness and then I synthesize. But I can always know what makes interest to me. I'm interested in health. I'm interested in nutrition, I'm interested in yoga, I'm interested in music, I'm interested in playing music, I'm interested in what's happening to people here, what different groups are doing to really enhance themselves as groups, how people band together during this pandemic. So there's so many stories out there. I'm interested in Tom Brady, so many stories. So you pick what makes sense for you. And what's going to happen is as you start to look for a topic, you're going to realize that you could do so many because there's so many things you're interested in. It's just one. For me, as your teacher, it's your first time presenting. Introduction, body, conclusion. You are reading chapter one right now, and you will see how important it is for you to understand that you as the speaker or the source, communicator one, are encoding out your message to your receivers. And every person who hears your message is going to have a different way of decoding that message depending on their worldview, how they see the world. You're going to be presenting through your worldview and they're going to be receiving and decoding through their worldview. And then comes back feedback. I don't know on page 4 in chapter 1, is it clear that communication is a complete circle and it doesn't go in reverse? So once you say something, it's been said. But all these presentations, and there's a handout for each one, are all meant to be simple and manageable. And you decide how you're going to present, what words you're going to use, what examples you're going to use. Are you going to bring in any visual aids? I have recently purchased some more essential oils. If I was doing a speech that had to do with essential oils, I might bring that up to the camera to be seen. But you do not need to have visual aids. And I don't want you using the computer like you might in the classroom with PowerPoints, none of that. This is pure. Our channel is the camera. And we are there to listen to you, so it's not like in the classroom. You can put your notes on index cards if you'd like. This is index cards. When I was a kid, that's all we could do. 45 years ago when I was in school, we had to use index cards. And our teachers would say, make sure you dog ear the ends so they don't stick together. And I wouldn't suggest more than 5 index cards. And your first index card might have your introduction. So on my handout, it says to introduce yourself and your topic. So I'd say, this is just an example. Hi, I'm Joyce Fernandes, and today I'm going to speak to you about Tom Brady and his career and how I first met Tom Brady as a sub for Drew Bledsoe, and how he became a national treasure. As they say, he's the GOAT, right? So that's who I am. That's my topic. And I got my information from CBS News. I am not collecting where you get your information from. I am trusting that you are getting reliable sources. But this is not English class where I'm going to ask you to pass in anything in MLA style. It's not like that. This is a little bit freer. You will see when you read chapters 1 and 2 that practicing oratory is stressful enough without putting more weight on the students. And then in the body, it says to paraphrase the story. So if you have a written story in front of you, like in a newspaper or a magazine, you're not reading us the story. You are reading it to you. You are digesting it. And then you are going to give us the details that are important to you to move the story along. And you might not have every single detail there, nor do you have to. This is just to start the conversation. This is starting the conversation. When we do the information speeches, you might have a little bit more breadth and depth to it. It'll have a little more time, but not for this speech. This is just our beginning. So you paraphrase the story. And then when you finish the story, you're going to give us your opinion, why you selected this. And you might find for this speech that the conclusion, because it's your opinion, might actually be a little longer than in another speech where you might have traditionally an information speech. You might have so many minutes or seconds for the introduction. The body will be bigger, and then the conclusion will be as big as the introduction. It won't be that long, but in this speech, it might be a little longer. Oh, I didn't finish my thought about note-taking. So you can put your notes on index cards, or you can use the method of writing out an outline. And what I do oftentimes is I use a clipboard. I use a clipboard and yellow line paper or white line paper, and I write down an outline. So I would have that right there for me to refer to. Now, if you're nervous and you find out this isn't going to work from an outline, you need to write it all out. That's another method of speech delivery. There are four methods. One is called the impromptu, where you just don't put any preparation. You just say, I know something I'm going to share. The danger with that is limiting yourself to 2 to 5 minutes and making sense and not dragging it on too much for your audience. You don't want to exhaust your audience. Believe me, I know what that's like because I do it to people all the time. And when I'm in a serious setting, like when I'm asked to speak, I'm very conscious about that. Like introductions are supposed to just give a good first impression, let the audience know what's going to be happening, and then the body does the work. Like I say, in this particular speech, in the news, you might have a longer conclusion than usual. But your notes have to be organized. So impromptu is one way. That's one speech delivery type that you just wing it. You just had an idea. And if you have the gift of gab and you can organize, your brain can do that, you can get away with it sometimes, but it's not a good practice. Another method is memory. You write it all out and then you memorize it. Memorize it like an actor or an actress would. You just memorize it like a script. The danger in that is too, if your brain gets tripped out or you miss a part, you could be like, feel like deer in the headlights. Your notes should be there to help you. And the other method is manuscript, where you're going to read the whole thing. But that's not a speech. That's a read. And that's not what we're here to practice. We're not practicing our oral communication skills for oral interpretation. We're practicing our oral skills for oratory, for real connection with the audience in the moment, not canned, not manufactured. So reading from a paper, that's not this class. This class is about you utilizing your brain cells and your power of speech and your good eye contact and body positioning and gesturing to convey a message. That's what this